show you how easy it is to set up an empirical calibration on our LAB-X5000. So just enter the PIN code. You have to log in manager mode. Scroll down and choose the calibration tab. Now we go down to the point new calibration and we have to enter a name. In our case, I want to show you how to set up an empirical calibration for phosphorus in liquids. So I enter the name. Okay. The next thing is we want to enter all our parameters. So now we have to select which element needs to be analyzed. We want to analyze the phosphorus and we have to choose the measurement conditions. We want to measure with 5 kV, 600 microamps and an open filter. We don't need helium in our case because of the air density correction. So the next thing is to enter the measurement time. 30 seconds are enough. The region of interest belongs to the phosphorus peaks and we want to include this element to our calibration. Now we have the option to choose the display name. So if you want to see only the P, or you can enter the name completely phosphorus or every name which is customized and best for you. You can choose the display unit. So if you want to measure in percentage or for example in ppm, and you can enter the number of decimals. So we only want to see one decimal and that's it. Go back and check. Now the phosphorus is put in our calibration. The next thing is we want to enter the standards. So we go to the step standards, press add and enter the name for the first standard. Our standard is A. And this standard does have a concentration of 0.5%. Now we can put in our standard. Because we are measuring liquid samples, we use a secondary safety film. This one will be put in the instrument first. It's to prevent the instrument against spillage of the sample. Then we can put our liquid sample in this sample cup inside the instrument and just press the start button. Now the standard A is measuring for 30 seconds and we see that the spectrum for our measurement conditions we defined before is preparing. Here you can see the time bar which is going down from 30 seconds to zero. When the measurement has finished, you can see that the measurement is complete and you can take your sample out of the instrument. When the first standard is successfully measured, you can press the add and place or give the name for the second standard. Again, the concentration for the second standard, it's 1.5%, and place the standard in the instrument and press the start button. We will repeat this procedure for all our standards we have for our calibration. Now all of the standards are measured and To check if all spectra are stored, you can go to the bottom and see here the spectrum. You can check for every single standard. And then we go to the next step. In the regression tab, you can compare the givens against the calculated values or the givens against the intensities for your phosphorus. You can also see all values compared to each other and all the parameters. Because we have here very straight, nice line, it is not necessary to put any correction in there. So our calibration is finished and we are ready to use it for our routine measurements. Now we want to measure an unknown sample against our calibration. We just go with the back to our start button and we check if the new calibration is selected on the top. Now we can take our unknown sample, but first check if the secondary safety window is still clean. We will put our unknown sample in the sample tray and just press the start button. Now we enter a name, let's say test, and say okay, and the measurement is automatically starting. We can see that the time bar is going down from 30 seconds to zero. Here you can see in live the actual concentration from our unknown sample and you see the standard deviation. When the measurement is finished, you get an information. And now you have the possibility to print out the results on the integrated printer and put this one to your unknown sample.